from Pulp Fiction, but with blonde hair, Monica.
I found my card. It's here.
Ah, okay. All right.
Okay.
Sorry, bro. All right. So we're all sorted.
I bet you don't feel it.
I know it's very loud and it's very imperfect, but
hello.
As Aza likes to say, it is.
I'm finally here.
Do you want to hear? Do you want to hear? I know, but can you talk into the mic?
Oh yeah, I can hear it better.
Can
now.
You hear yourself?
Yes.
Alright, okay. So that's good enough. That's good enough for now. Oh, we can turn ourselves up actually, so we're a little bit louder. Is that alright?
It's good, yeah.
Monika, you still are the first person that I wanted to have on my podcast from the very beginning.
But I was very shy about it.
What do you tell me?
I had to get my perfect haircut to join the podcast.
Well, I can't believe it. When I arrived at Sweet Hostel, I was like, where's Monika? And it's like, oh, she's working for BP now, so like, you know, like she'll come eventually. And by then, Stefan jumped on and a couple of other people. And by then I lost track and I was like, no, Monika was supposed to be the first person.
I had my 16th jobs, you know.
What?
I had my 16th jobs to do, so.
Are you happier now that you're working in a more stable situation?
Do
you feel like you've grown up in Budapest?
I am so proud of myself in Budapest.
I am proud of you too.
Like, I came here in age of 24 when I literally just dropped my studies. So in eyes of people, like, you drop your studies, you're 24, you don't really have like decent experience. You seriously don't know what to do, and I really didn't know where I would go, and I had no idea. And look at me, 9 years later, I'm actually having really like responsible job, which I got based on my experience, which I gained, like from other people. Like, some people might know, but like, I'm working in sourcing. And I have the senior position. I'm negotiating I'm working for BP, like British Petroleum.
Yeah.
Every freaking contract which they sign in Poland has to go through me. So you know what? From one hand, I don't feel like better than other people, but I feel so fucking proud of myself that without degree and sub, I got to this freaking point to do it.
What did people say when you decided to move here? People back home, you must have had friends back home, family obviously, but like your whole life you just abandoned within the blink of an eye.
Because it was like bad point in my life, like I didn't know what to do there and I was kind of lost, and it just literally was the point when I was like,
wait a second, Monika, wait a minute. I've got like a
Murphy size
knot I gotta undo here. Alright, that's better.
I had no clue what I'm going to do, and I felt like, my life in Poland, what the fuck I'm gonna do? Like, there was...
But what was your first point of call? Like, where was the first job you actually... Was it a hostel?
Here? Yeah.
Which one?
Big Fish.
Big Fish. Ah. And you did reception work?
Reception, cleaning, whatever. Like, it was like, you know, like the same at Sweet Hostel. Like, you basically volunteer, you get like free bed, like food and stuff. And
then after that, what did you find?
And in the meantime, like, because I had, like, I really thought that there is no way you don't speak language. And in actually 2013, it was not like you can find job just with English or Polish. But like, I found on the Facebook group this guy saying, hey, we're looking like Polish speakers for like basically like call center job, but they named this nicely like IT support because you were resetting other people's passwords. And you know what? Even though it was IT, it was for me like more than I could imagine.
Yeah.
And it was serious interview whole day and stuff, and I was so wanted to get it. And I got it, and they told me, like, I was expecting salary like 100 20,000 forints per month, and they said it's like 220.
Oi.
9 years ago, 220 fucking foreign salary. When I told the people at the hostel, when I asked them, guys, do you think it's good salary? Because I had no clue. They were like, it's like 100 more what we are getting.
Wow.
And that's how it started.
So you were set from that point on?
Yeah, like then I, after 1.5 year, when I kind of met people and, hi Claudia, Camila.
Camila.
Hello, beautiful. Come on. Thank you. I can feel your hands on my back.
Are you going to keep podcasting in a whole
just a little
time?
Just a little bit. We're running it.
I have to stand up. Stop the podcast anyway.
One second. I'll join you guys in a second, okay?
Hey, hello.
Okay.
Hi. I just wanted to massage you.
It's
so
fine.
It's also happening live.
We have to make an appointment next week.
Yes.
Monika, I remember when we first met, you were skinny, short, pixie head.
So you say I'm not skinny anymore? I'm fat.
No, you're curvy now. You've got actually, like, when I say skinny, like, you were super skinny. Like, you were, skinny. Now you're healthy. But I remember you had the short hair,
red
punk red hair.
But you know how the red hair happened?
Wow.
Because when I came here, didn't I have a red hair?
No.
And I had longer hair.
Really?
Yeah.
But I don't remember you
lost the bed at the hostel.
Before you met me?
Yeah.
Oh, really? At the suite?
There was a bed that if I lose, I will dye my hair to red.
And cut it short?
No. But I was like, if I dye it to red, I will cut it first, so it will be easy to recover.
All right.
I went to the hairdresser.
What was the bed?
Something very party stupid. I don't remember.
Oh, man.
It was with the guests at the hostel, and they didn't believe me. When they saw me with the red hair, they said, like, we were joking, we really didn't want to. But they were like, it looks cool. Like, I don't think it looked cool, like, at the moment, but I'm kind of happy I went through the different phases, because otherwise I would probably never have enough courage to do it.
So you had to have the bet to actually take the step to do it. I'm trying to remember the first time we met. It would have been at Sweet Hostel.
Yeah.
You would have been working, maybe.
When we met at the Sweet Hostel, I wasn't working.
Do you remember? Do you remember the first time we met?
Yes.
You do?
Yes. I remember. You guys went to some cave party somewhere.
Yes.
And I came in the morning and I brought McDonald's for everyone.
You fucking did! Oh my god, Monika! But I swear I met you before that.
No, that was the first time. That's when I met you, Lawrence, and Josh. I remember.
Wow. Fucking hell. That's crazy.
Yeah.
And it's like 2013, so it's like nearly 10 years ago. You know, like, Joshy, Lawrence, and Owen, and we made this pact that they would visit each other's countries one day. Never happened, but, like, it just reminds you of all the
crazy from other parts of the world, and so difficult, especially your life move on. So, like, I met you, like, even when, like, so Stefan I see regularly, and Stefan is like, seriously, like, if fucking you would hear this, like, you are like one of the best, like,
Stefan.
When my brother was diagnosed with MS, Stefan literally posted him the peak, like, he's one of the drawing with the special decay. Stefan met my brothers, he loves them. And they love him as well. And Josh came here when Alina got pregnant to just come here and tell me in person that she got pregnant. Wow. I mean, like, we had so many.
Really? So how did he break it to you?
Like, it was fucking crazy.
How?
We went to the bar together. Like,
Which bar?
He stayed at my place. We went together to the bar, like, one of the streets with the burgers. And we had so many tequilas. We are walking home and he said, like, who knows when again I will be able to travel, because you know, Alina is pregnant, and I'm like drunk, and I'm like, are you fucking shitting me?
Were you there when he proposed to her?
I was recording.
You were there.
You were recording.
So yeah, like, and they got married on my birthday.
Not deliberately.
No, but like, it's great for like it's so great. So yeah, but then Lawrence came here and I couldn't see him because I was just
Lawrence. He's the one that slipped away because he's got a married, settled life
he's
now.
He's serious boy right now.
But you know the thing is, like, he's been replaced by Dylan, who's from South Africa, and the same
shit that
Lawrence used to talk about, Dylan's talking about the same thing.
Is Dylan also in love with Vanessa?
Oh, Vanessa. Oh.
Shut up.
Oof.
Shut up.
Are you still in touch with her?
Hey.
Do you have her details? Friend number?
No.
We all had a little bit of a crush on Vanessa. But she was cool. Like, you know, she
but
actually
she
gave
was
her time.
Not as cool as Yaz.
Perish the thought. Yaz is the fucking... Don't get me started. Wait, I don't have a drink.
Yeah, you don't have a drink. Like, I'm like, why am I?
Yeah. What's that beer over there? Pass me that.
It
doesn't look like anyone's. Yeah. That... All right, okay. Now. No, Yaz is the fucking coolest. And it's so weird that you knew Yaz. She was like the first
She's
person.
She's the first person I met in freaking... Hungary.
Wow. Was she an influence for you staying?
It was difficult.
But what was the thing that made you stay? I wanted you to tell me. Come on. This is what I wanted to know on the podcast. Get closer to the mic.
The thing which made me stay
was that
I had nothing to go back.
Yeah, but what was the moment you realized? Because you didn't come here to intend to stay. You're representation of the black hole of Budapest that I have.
At that point of time in Krakow, I was having nothing, and I didn't belong anywhere.
Why did you come to Budapest?
Because I hope Tito doesn't. He can say it. Like, so the last flat I was renting with flatmates. They went for the long weekend because it was holidays in Poland, and it was around Halloween, and two Aussie guys were looking for meeting or in the best case scenarios, like couch surfing, they can actually crash in.
Yeah.
I invited them, and one of them was quite cute, and he was working at the hostel which Yas was kind of managing with her ex-boyfriend.
Wait for it.
Alex.
You met
What's your name?
I know we have, but I'm not
Alex.
Alex.
Monika.
You're an Alex.
Monika.
That's an Alex and there's two Alexes.
Two Alexes. He just wanted to say happy.
There's a third one on that right now. So, it was on Wednesday.
Well, the price of the
more than
you need.
Why don't you two get up and sing a song? Why don't you sing a song? You guys pick a song and sing.
What was the moment that you realized?
Like, they stayed at my place, and it turned out that Leon, that was the name of the guy, he's actually kind of working, volunteering in the hostel, which Yas and her ex-boyfriend were managing. And he told me, like, so they're supposed to stay with me just for, like, two nights, but they stayed 1 week. And then the guy said, come to fucking Budapest, there's a pool party tomorrow. You just come for one night and you're like,
are you fucking serious?
And that's
you went for a pool party.
Yeah. So I just arrived here at 10 p.m. Then I saw Yasmin sitting in the corridor and I said, I'm Monika. She said, I'm Yasmin. I fucking remember this. It was first thing, so I remember these things. And then next morning I was so hungover that there was no way I would go home. So I booked ticket for a few more days, but then it was so good and stuff. And I was like, okay, no. And then I met this Polish girl when the things went wrong with me and Yas in the future. So she kind of, but like, even though I have a lot of regrets to this and stuff, but she was also the reason why I stayed.
Just call it as it is. So she helped you stay.
Yeah.
She, but you give me the moment, Monika. Give me the moment when you realize, okay, now I'm deciding to stay.
No, I never had the moment. There was a moment. Look.
It just happened.
Look, I think that the first real moment when I was, like, I don't think I had the moment. I don't think... Because, like, you know, I didn't go home at all. So my parents and stuff, I didn't see them. So I cannot say when I had the moment I stayed. Maybe I don't even have this moment until today that I stayed. I just, like, yeah. That's what I realize right now. I never had the pep. I've never had the moment. And until now, I don't have the moment when I said,
I'm going to stay. You've just been here.
It's just still,
you've
like,
just been
one
here.
Goal. Yeah.
Fucking no.
I'm serious. Because, like, I never thought about this like this. But when you asked me...
No, because, you like, haven't had
you know
that moment.
I was thinking already like three or whatever times to go back home when very significant times and bad things with either my family or something happened in Budapest or some breakups. I was really considering that, you know, like, I'm done here. Maybe it's time to stop it and go home.
But what would
then,
keep you here?
Then you know, something's other happened. And then, you know, I adopted freaking, like, I never want to have a dog. And now I have
that's
the
a commitment.
Best dog in the world. Like,
best dog in the world.
But, like...
My favorite.
And, you know,
pooch.
Like, the craziest thing was when I was renting the apartment by myself. I sat down in this apartment once with my friend. I was drunk. And for the first time ever, I looked at her and I said something like that. It was like 3 years ago. I was like, look, 5 years ago, I was almost homeless in Krakow. I did not really talk to my family. I had nothing. I dropped my studies. I was just like broken as fuck and I didn't know when I would sleep tomorrow. Now? Sitting in the freaking apartment by myself, which I'm paying for, I have the most amazing dog next to me. I have you and other friends next to me who I even talked about my past and they didn't turn back on me. And I have this job when people say me I'm amazing too and I can bigger position. They offer me this because I'm great. And how the I didn't even think that I did something to do it. But when I think about it, I did a lot.
You did, Monika.
But like, I'm still amazed to this point how my life just literally. But like, it was luck. It was also luck. It wasn't just a hard work. Like, no.
Do you believe in fate?
Yeah, like I believe not maybe in fate, but I believe in luck.
Do you think luck comes from hard work? That if you work hard enough, something will give?
Not necessarily, because I know a lot of people who work the freaking
and they don't have
hard
any
and they don't have any. So no, I don't.
But what about if it's a perspective? Did you have a sense that you knew, like, you can envision yourself here, or was it just playing it, like, literally
never,
week
ever,
by week?
Never in my life I envision anything in my life. Like, from the when I was a child, I never knew what I want to do in my life. Now I'm doing something that I freaking love. Plus, I will start delivering food on vlog soon.
Yeah.
You know, I cannot do just one job.
You're getting on the bus. No, of course.
It's not that my company doesn't pay well. I just, you know, can have too much free time.
One second, Monika.
No worries.
Just a little kiss, just a little kiss.
We'll finish up here now. I finally got you here, Monika.
And I'm here.
I think, you know, like, considering you were meant to be my first guest, because you were the representation of what Budapest is for. The city that brings people in who don't expect to stay, who stay. Like, your story I've told to so many people about Budapest, to describe what Budapest is like.
Wait 1 second. Can you get
a
1-2-3 shots of tequila?
Again? Oh, yeah.
You know what? I'll give you some money. Gold, 3 shots.
Oh, you can
Monika. Oh, she's giving out money. Hold on, I'm going to get
money. All right, fine. Now I got a fucking new change, yeah?
Sorry.
Will you?
No, fuck. I have all the money.
So many photos.
I know.
Send them to me.
I will.
I'm sorry. I forgot. I didn't have to mention it.
All drunk and shit.
Oh, sick. Yeah, you got to send me it. Can you send it?
I will tomorrow. When I've sobered up and I'll...
I've seen you snapping away all night.
Because... one of life's great lessons. Life is about collecting memories and scars, but only the memories fade.
You can tell, right?
Nah, you shave for a living.
Nah, you see my scars.
You know, Bondi is our teammate in the pub quiz.
Actually, you know what?
Wait, let me give him a meal.
Bondi, you introduced me with a Bondi. I remember at Yellow. You changed my life, Monika. Not even before the whole like you did.
Right, and I'll tell you how. Now,
when I came and met you and Stefan at that pub, and you had Becca there, and I took her for a little walk, and then I was with this other girl, Daria, and you said, "Come out to open mic at Yellen, my boyfriend's playing."
Yeah.
I went there, had an amazing time. I met Aza. Aza said, "All right, you know, let's we'll catch up someday." The next night, Aza was at Sweet Hostel with Yasmin, and Aza introduced me to Yasmin.
I remember. Yeah.
So that night when we met up with you and Stefan in that bar was a pivotal moment in my life. I mean, apart from all of the catalysts for coming to Budapest.
Life is, for me, the life in Budapest changed my life. I would never achieved anything. I would probably maybe not even talk to my family right now if I would not be in Budapest.
Yeah.
It just...
Budapest is like, it's stuck the opportunity.
I never want to have a dog by myself. Now I can't live without her. Like, there's so much, like... And I met Tito, and he's like freaking greatest boyfriend in the world. Like, seriously, he is.
That's beautiful. Do you reckon you'll get married?
I'm not that...
You're not keen on marriage?
It's not something what I really, really need.
Do you reckon I'll have kids?
No, but I'm serious. Oh, kids? No, I don't want to have kids.
You got Becca. That's enough, right?
No, like, kids for me, it's like... I have so many reasons why I don't have kids. Just really, like... And luckily him as well, so...
Where do you see... Okay, before we wrap up, Monika, because we want to join the rest of the party. Where do you see yourself in 5 years' time? Still in Budapest?
Oh, man.
What do you want to be? Where do you want to be? What do you want to be doing?
I will never answer you this question. Like, look what's
this
happening.
Is the thing.
Just like...
I know. You don't...
It's impossible to say.
I know. But forget about all this. Like, it... Just imagine.
There's no answer. Answer. Like, Tita is mad when I say answer. It's answer.
Would you be happy if things stayed the way they are? In your life, not... In the world at large, but in your life?
Like it is right now. Like, I don't know. Like, I'm happy right now, but there's always place to make things better. Like, I just, like, before I thought that it cannot be better and it's just deep shit and you know. But now, when I got what I have, I really think it's always things which can improve it. And you might not know how, but with life, you just get there, you know? It's just like weird. It might sound weird, but I seriously... Like, talking to you right now, I have to overthink this thing and think, and I thought it would be hard, but it's not. Like, it's actually a good thing to realize that I'm so proud of myself.
Yes.
I'm so proud of you. Like, I'm so happy about you and Yas. I'm so happy about me and Tito. And in all of this, we have Arwin, which is maybe like weird to live with him, but like, it's normal for me. The whole story is just kind of like...
The whole story.
Like,
I really
want to...
I really feel like I want to write this as a story.
Both of us, we started here to be completely fucked by our lives.
Yeah.
Like, we were both so fucking lost. Maybe in a different time of time, but we were lost and fucked. But the thing changed and... Now we are not. Now we are happy. Both of us are happy.
We're here. We live in Budapest. Like,
we live in
Hungary.
We're happy.
Yes.
We have jobs.
Yes, we have work.
And you know what? Like,
we have healthy relationships.
Our other friends who never believe in us would never say, like, oh, you... Like, they would think you would be homeless, whatever. We're not homeless. We are doing better than them. We are not, like, poisoned. We are, like...
We made it. We're doing it.
Honestly, like, you know, I had this very bad time when I got banned by Retox for being the drug dealer.
Really?
I didn't know that.
I didn't know you got banned from Retox.
Oh, yeah.
This is a story for another time.
For being a drug dealer. Me, drug dealer. Can you imagine?
You're the most fucking saintly person when it comes to that.
You have my chance? Oops, I did it again.
Oh, shit, yeah.
Only pay 5,000 for three shots.
Oh, no, sorry. This is on.
Oh, God, now Britney Spears has come up, folks.
That's
I will pay you next one,
though. You pay me shit, bro.
Oi, is it Yo-Yo's birthday now?
So you didn't know about the thing when I was... you want to hear the story?
That's another time, for another time. We're going to do our own special podcast, just the two of us. And actually, you know what? I want to get you and Arwin and me. And if Stefan shows up one day, the ultimate dream is to have Joshy on as well. And Lawrence, but I think we can say Lawrence is well and truly in his life now. But at least you, me, and Arwin, we have to do a podcast together properly. Thank you, Monika. Thank you, Polly.
This one.
Yeah, just... Oh, wait, fuck. I've got to get a chase. This is tequila, right?
Yeah. So you want some?
Just fine. Quick before the taste creeps in. Oh, that's a good follow-up, actually. Man, I'll never forget those Polish drinks you brought back from Poland. They were the fucking best. Oh.
Every every time.
When was the last time you were back in Poland?
Last time? December 2019.
Get closer to the mic, I can't hear you.
December 2019.
Oh yeah.
Well, I'm going on June 17th. And for the first time ever, I'm taking Becca.
She's gonna see the homeland.
My parents will lose their shit because my parents used to have a dogs, but never ever in bed, on the sofa and stuff. And you know,
they're
Becca,
gonna freak out.
Becca is complete opposite. I told my parents, you cannot say her. She cannot go on the sofa because you know what? She has to be on the sofa.
Yeah, that's her spot.
But yeah, we used to have a dogs which were like love to spend time outside. So I understand my parents. They didn't want them to come inside.
But Becca is such an inside dog.
But Becca is not dirty at all. She's like, you know, Becca.
She's pure.
Yeah.
She's clean as a priest sheet. Hey! Monica.
We should finish.
Yeah, let's
we
wrap
have
up.
Too many people.
Thank you so much. This has actually been really fucking really cool.
I actually enjoyed it, so you should do the proper one.
We'll do a proper one. This is the birthday version.
Well, I can still sit here and invite other people.
Yeah, of course you can. You can go hog wild. Get Alex on.
You have something to tell me.
Just because you want to get out of it, yeah.
Since now I want to invite you for the podcast.